first single, Hands Up for Flood?
Yeah!
I'm not sure.
I need to think about it a little.
Let's play second singles.
No, I need to think about it a little bit.
Have you decided? Is it going to be the Flood?
I think it should be the Flood.
Yeah, you and me, we can ride.
I think you guys really should be working for the UN for some kind of diplomatic corps, because it's incredible that you actually got back together again. What is the trick to this reconciliation?
I don't know, but it's beautiful.
It
really is. And because I follow other bands, obviously, and other bands break up and then they fall out with each other. And somehow, miraculously, we've all grown up a bit and we've all taken responsibility for our own actions. Kind of go, this is why I was upset with you, because this happened. And then the other person goes, yeah, that did happen, I'm really sorry. And then the same thing to me, and back and forth, and off we go. And you know, it's when another individual can go, yeah, I did that, and I'm really sorry, and I plan not to do that again. If you don't do that...
Mark, you've said that you were pop stars before you were ever men. Mm. What was it like in the early days of Take That?
I remember a lot of fear around the band, but I think a lot of that maybe my mind put on myself as well, and things can become bigger. I just didn't know who I was, my position, my standing. I didn't know who I was as a person.
But the thing about you guys too is you've been very honest, and I think that, you know, music aside, that is why people connect to you. You've been honest about facing your demons, facing your addictions. But do you think you would have had to face your addictions if you hadn't become so massively famous?
I think it's hypothetical. I was on the way there. You know, if I look at my childhood and saw how I ate, or how I played, or how I was with, you know, women, or how I was with anything that you can be addicted to, I was addicted to it. So I was heading that way anyway. I think it just probably sped up the process because we've got the money to spend on the stuff. You know, so I would say, yeah, I'd probably been well an addict. Would you have been well an addict too, Mark?
I would have been well an addict, man, well an addict.
Yeah. You both would have well been
addicts. It is funny because I do, I mean, in different ways, but I think it is something that I noticed in my parents, you know, whether it was work or, you know, you can, this addiction comes in many forms, I guess.
What are you addicted to today?
Today?
The limelight.
No, cigarettes.
At the height of your fame as a solo artist, I mean, poor old Gary. Gary even wanted to change his name there at one stage because things were so bad for him. Do you regret some of the things you said about Gary during that time?
I regret that, you know, there was many years where it had actually gone past me being angry. Mm. But it was still part of my script. Still part of the Robbie routine. Also, it was the kind of time to be bitter and resentful and a new lad. And, you know, Britpop was kicking off. Everybody was doing coke and drinking an awful lot. And people were having fights, public fights and public spats. A, I was really angry towards Gaz. And B, that was all going on. So I just joined in.
There are pitfalls, of course, to fame. You can end up being a prisoner in your own house. You actually said you stayed inside for 3 years. Is that true?
Yeah. You know, but, you know, I don't really see it as being a prisoner to my fame. Nobody knows who I am in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
You know, so it's... that's the same, to be honest with you.
Bit of a recluse.
Yeah. You know, but a happy recluse, too. You know, he likes a bevy with his pals. And if he didn't have a bevy with his pals, he'd quite happily shut the world away and sit there and do whatever he does and be very, very happy, thank you very much. Mm-hmm. And I am too. I'm in Los Angeles. It's sunny.
How's Ida?
She's fantastic. Yeah.
You loving married life?
Yeah.
Yeah,
she's really special and getting more and more special every day. You know, I'm kind of realising more and more what I've got. Mm. You know, and it's really cool. Really, really cool.
I know that feeling.
You feeling content?
Yeah, just realising what you've got as well. It's incredible.
Musically, though, when you think of it, you've created some incredible tunes. Have you surprised yourself with what you have achieved? And not just from record sales, just in the fact that people love listening to your music.
You know, I think a certain section of people have always kind of liked listening to our music, you know, and we've done really well over the last 20 years. The honest answer is, before we started to do this album, I knew it was going to be brilliant. I had a feeling in my bones that, you know, I'm really pleased about the critical acclaim that the album's received. I'm not surprised by it, no. I don't see why, you know, the five of us together couldn't come up with a blinding album.
You just blow other boy bands out of the water, though, don't you? I mean, because they're not coming up with their own tunes.
We can't say that when we're in Ireland. You have a couple here.
to be honest, boy bands, indie bands, whoever bands, this album blows them out of the water.